Christ said that he has given us power to trample upon scorpions and serpents, referring to demonic forces and worldly contention. He said we have power to trample upon scorpions and serpents, and nothing shall by no means harm us. He did not say that by no means scorpions and serpents will not appear. It is because scorpions or serpents appear that we need the power to trample upon them. So Christ never told you that by no means no persecution and no affliction will happen. So stop this fairy tale. Actually, it's not even a fairy tale. It's worse than a fairy tale. Because even in fairy tales, there is a fight before the lead character has the victory. In every Disney story or in every Hollywood movie, there is some fight that the protagonist needs to overcome. And that is the glory of the story. And what happens now? Now you have believers who've been contaminated by pagan Christianity. They think that if you do God's will, everything will be easy and you'll have a smooth ride on the earth. No, you won't. Absolutely not. As a believer, until Christ returns, you will go through persecution. But you don't have to go through persecution the same way you went through last year. You don't have to be harmed by persecution if you know how to overcome and anticipate persecution. Even unbelievers face affliction at the hands of other unbelievers. So if worldlings treat each other like that, how do you think they're going to treat you who doesn't belong to this world anymore? Come on. Let go of this fantasy. Or better said, it's not a fantasy. Let me correct myself. Let go of this delusion that you will have an easy ride, easy circumstances when you do God's will. You can have easy circumstances, but those easy circumstances will be the result of you overcoming. That's when you will have easy circumstances, when you overcome. There isn't overcoming. And it's only overcoming because there's a fight. So the fight will come. The offenses will come. The fights will come. Be prepared in faith to overcome them. Look, there are many things believers go through that they could have easily avoided if they walked by faith. I'm not saying we can avoid everything, every bad thing that comes our way. I'm not saying that. But what I'm saying is most of the stuff that believers go through, they could have easily avoided them. They could have easily bypassed them if they looked at the bigger picture. So believers, understand the following. If you encounter more difficulties than a commoner, that's good news because you are a believer. And as a believer, it's expected that the enemy seeks to restrict you. Why would the enemy restrict someone who has nothing to offer? You have the anointing. You have strength. That's why the enemy wants to drain you and restrict you. Those that are lost, what do they have? Yes, they have their human energy fields that demons want to drain. But besides that, what else do they have? They don't. So demons are feeding off of them by keeping them in a cycle. That's the only thing. That's why they are relaxed and at ease in their cycles. Yes, they have difficulties, but they have minor stuff in general. That's because they're lost. So you should never compare yourself to them anyway. But even those commoners who have a relaxed cycle, not relaxed in the sense that they never go through something, but they have this ease in the cycle, even they know that when someone has some type of significance, that they will face resistance. And there are even commoners who look at those churchgoers and think, hold on a minute, how come you serve the Lord who was crucified, yet people leave you alone? Or how come you serve the Lord who rose from the dead? He was crucified and he rose from the dead. So he rose from the dead, right? So why don't you have victory in your life circumstances? There are commoners who are more alert than believers. Please, believers, let all those delusions go. Learn to walk by faith. Be at peace.